There is a brand new option in Zoom that I'm really excited to explore, see how it works, and test it out. Why don't you join me and let's take a look together? But you can only see it if the situation is relevant. What I'm talking about is sharing screen into the breakout rooms. I'm really excited to test this out further. I've only taken a quick look at it previously, and I really want to see what does it look like for the participants? How does this work? In order to do that, we need to first have the breakout rooms launched. So I'm going to bring some people here with me. Okay, so yes, I am here four times. This is a good way of me quickly showing you what this will look like. So first of all, I need to set us up all in a breakout room, and I will see you there. Everyone else is in the breakout room. It is going right now. Got the time, I can broadcast a message, and I'll link videos that talk about all of those steps and tips about breakout rooms. But now in the main room, I could have multiple breakout rooms going, and I will test that out with multiple breakout rooms. But if I click share screen, brand new, so exciting, is this share to breakout rooms. So I do want to click sound. I could be sharing the PowerPoint slide. And what I will do is click share to breakout rooms. Okay, so that's interesting. The share sound doesn't occur. So I may not be able to share a video. So we'll test out a couple things. I'm going to share screen and then share screen to all breakout rooms. Your video and audio will not be shared with breakout rooms. Interesting. Screens with others are sharing in the breakout rooms will stop. Okay, so share. So if you had a case study that you wanted all of them to see, and I'm going to be testing out a couple things with this as a breakout room as well. So I'm checking my other computers. It worked. And I'm going to show you what that looks like. Okay, so as the host, what I just showed you, now I'm in a breakout room as a participant. The host is going to just share something into the breakout room. So in the breakout room, this is what it looks like. And if the host even goes through a couple things, but what I do want to test out is that you're not hearing anything. It's really just going to be without sound, I believe, but I'm going to test something out. So that is what it looks like. It's fantastic that you could share a screen. Now here in the breakout room, annotation's not coming up. So that's what I want to check out as well. So we can't draw on it, but we could have it as a visual that the case study, or like everyone's seeing the same thing at the same time and talking about it. I do want to test out if we can share a video as well.
So I popped in here. I couldn't share from my mobile device into the breakout room. That didn't come up as an option.
Okay, so what is interesting is, oh, it looks like it's only a host and co-host option. Okay, so when I play this back, I will see if you heard me when I was just sharing my video, sharing my screen, if you heard the video sounds, or if it is without sound. Now I just shared a whiteboard. So I'm going to, oh, this is cool. So I can't, in a breakout room, draw on this. But as the host or co-host, I may be able to draw something there. I'm going to try that now. So I'm looking forward to playing back this recording. Well, that was super exciting to explore with you. I hope you enjoyed this video, that it was helpful as a tutorial, as an idea generator for you too. I hope some light bulbs went off for you for how you can use this as a facilitator to increase engagement, make the learning experience online even more seamless. Thanks for watching. Again, my name is Patricia Regier with Regier Educational Services. We're here to help you facilitate engaging learning experiences. If you like this video, giving it a thumbs up, sharing it with others, and commenting definitely helps spread the great information to others like you. And if this channel is helpful to you, if you hit the subscribe button and the notification button, then you'll find out when different videos about Zoom, about other tools that help you as a facilitator, and some other resources that you can use in your day-to-day workplace training or when you're creating learning materials. Thanks again, and until next time, I hope that you have some more light bulb learning moments.